What's up, everyone? It is 7 a.m. in the morning on a Monday, and I can't get to sleep, and I am very sleep deprived, and I want to talk about RTX. This one will probably have some light editing to help with the... Alright, well, already we got the God rays going on there, so that's good. Yeah, I was watching someone play, You remember the old, like, tech demo using Quake 2 that came out? I don't know why I didn't just load that one up, but... Oh, look, across. But... It got me thinking, because, like, that thing came out. I'll probably just superimpose a little bit of, footage onto it so you can see what I'm talking about, but... That thing came out. Right around the beginnings of RTX, and it was trying to show off what the technology could do and all that, and using an older kind of game to do it so that it can show off a lot better without having to be too slow and chunky. This is not working out at all. I have RTX on here. You can kind of see it, I guess. It works really well with Minecraft, but... I'm gonna load up my creative world, because... Called it Shiny AF. So... There's a little bit of discussion going on. I did do some things since the last time I worked on this world, but not much. There's some discussion going on about, like, is it even worth having? Like, is it ready yet? And my personal answer is, I don't know, but this sure is pretty. I think just a few years ago, it would have been seen as impossible with, Minecraft. But I got a shader specifically for RTX, and it's working great in Java Edition, but not in the Bedrock Edition, which has its own built-in RTX, which sucks, and you need to find your own texture pack for it, and it's... Freaking sucks. I'm using a 3060, like I said in other videos before, and my 3060 isn't the best in the world, but it is far from the worst. You see what it's pulling off here. All this wonderful, fancy lighting, shadows, and shading, reflections and stuff, and it just looks great. It really does. Until you, like, really stare at it. And you see, like, the particles. It looks fantastic in motion. And it still looks great standing still. But, like... At the same time, you can tell... You can tell that there's some fuckery going on there. So... The discussion seems to be around, like, the utility of it. Like, what is RTX good for other than making things shiny? And I was thinking about this for a little bit. And if you remember Doom 3 way back in 2004... One of the biggest deals of that game was its advanced lighting for the time, which still looks fantastic to this day. The game itself looks like it came out in 2004 for sure, but the lighting is used in such a nice artistic kind of way that just, you know, it enhances the gameplay. It had the shadows that, you know, let you see like the shadows of enemies around corners and stuff. And that was used for the gameplay. So, I think something similar could be done with RTX. And I'll pull up a few more examples here, 'cause what was it? Nvidia had that I'm gonna just stop up here so I not yeah not th this I still like this room. I still really like this room actually. But what was it? Like the thing where they like gave you the tools to take an old game and RTX it yourself? Yeah, I've seen a few of those projects. So the Quake 2 one was a more official kind of thing, but there was also a Quake 1 one. And you know what? Screw it. I don't care if you guys see my desktop or not. Don't you dare tell me. Oh, there it goes. Okay. My downloads folder? I ain't got nothing incriminating on here. Pretty sure. No! It would be where Quake is actually installed, which would be Steam. So, Quake. Probably up here in favorites. Browse local files, and it should be. Should be in here. Quake 95, ST, Vulcan, Windquake. All the usuals. Dark places. My favorite source port, by the way. ST? Gfix.what? That's not right. Where the problem with me trying to do this? Copper is I can't remember where the fuck I put these things. Maybe I made a shortcut to it in the games folder. Doom RTX, you know what? We'll pull up that one for now. Quake 2 RTX. Quake 1 RTX. All right, we'll do Doom second, but I wanna talk something about where I start seeing like cracks in the whatever, cracks in the logic behind like, remember the meme of RTX on and all that. And look, this looks fine. This looks nice. I like it. I think Quake 1 benefits greatly from having like advanced lighting effects, which is why I said that like Dark Places is my favorite because it's got that. But this is using straight up ray tracing, and if you don't really know what ray tracing even is, essentially, it uses advanced hardware. Ray tracing is not a new thing specifically. Like any kind of like pre-rendered like movie, like Pixar movie or whatever, anything like that uses ray tracing. But RTX uses the ray tracing in real time instead of like having to be rendered over like a long time or so. So it would render it in real time so that you can use it in video games. And what it would do was it would have a light source. You would have any light source, every light source, as you're looking around. And it would basically emulate the way real light happens. Which is to say, it creates a bunch of waves, or particles. Light is both particles and waves, which is weird, but like, that's science. That's sciencey stuff. and we're talking about video games, which is also like sciencey stuff. But yeah, essentially it completely simulates like those rays of light in a realistic type fashion, and maybe you can see it. Maybe you're just looking at this footage going, it looks fancy. And I agree. It looks very fancy. But can't really just throw RTX into anything and have it work. And I don't know the specifics. I'm gonna go ahead and start a new campaign, new game. And I don't know why they decided to make this room so foggy, but you see where the light's happening there. And with me playing, I'll be able to show better things. What's going on there? Because it's not really reflecting anything. But it's using RTX for something. And I don't know how well I'm going to get my point across with this video because of YouTube's like compression and my OBS settings and all that. Okay, immediately, alright, I don't know if you could see it or not, but like, what if I do, can you see like the spottiness? That kind of happens. It's because it's simulating light, but it can't do it at the speed of light, which is why when you're playing a game with RTX on, it looks kind of fuzzy and grainy a lot of the time. And I don't know what's up with this specific version of Quake that's doing that. That's making it fade out, like, you remember those, like, you probably don't, but, like, this toy, this Nickelodeon thing, whatever it was called, and, like, it created shadow, like, you could make a shadow, and then you flashed a light on it, and then that shadow would stay for, like, a few seconds, and then slowly fade. That was like a toy back in the 90s. And I don't know if I'll feel like looking up an image of it or not. But you get the gist, though. That's what this feels like. Granted, the effect isn't nearly as bad. Or good, I should say. That fog effect is nice, though. I can't ignore the spottiness. Also, I think maybe the brightness is too high. Not really getting the full effect here, I think. Oh, and this friggin' thing. Oh, wait, hold on. You see that? So, essentially what that is, this is something that's interesting. You got the Nvidia one and you got the AMD, and I don't know why it's different between the two. It has something to do with, I guess, whether you're using DirectX or Vulkan or OpenGL or whatever. But, essentially what this does is, and look, when I turn it off, my computer's fan immediately starts going crazy and the frame rate is going down. Is like very stuttery now. It's because it's running it at full frame rate or full resolution, full 1080p. If I turn it on and I set it to quality here, what it essentially does is It lowers the resolution of the game itself. It lowers the resolution, the actual game's resolution. And then uses, like, AI in real time to upscale it, essentially. And I don't know why. Like, I do not mind the effect. You can kind of see it. Maybe not in this game, but in, like, much more detailed games that use the same thing. But you can tell if you're looking hard enough, and you can see, like, how the AI is doing its best to try and recreate the image. And then the resulting effect is, you know, a similarly high resolution image, but with better frame rates. Hold on. I got one for you. Portal with RTX. This is the one where I really noticed, like, the effects of it. And for some reason, out of all the games I got on here, this is the one that gives my GPU the most trouble. Give it a second. I think it's reinstalled onto my portable hard drive, so... Okay, yeah, so Alt-X to access their RTX menu. Yeah, Nvidia Remix, that's... RTX Remix, that's the thing. Holy crap, even the bald head dude's thing is lagging. Holy crap, it's lagging so much! It's because it's loading the enhancements, that's why. But this game is quite gorgeous, but, like, it's just kind of silly to me, like, the amount of workarounds the graphics card and the software has to do to get it to work at an acceptable level. I don't know, it's just silly. I think we just gotta slow it down. I think it's still loading. That's not... Okay, there it goes. Holy crap, look at it try. Look at this poor thing. Like I said, it's... I probably have it installed on my portable hard drive to save space, so... It won't be as snappy as my computer's built-in SSD. Okay, it's looking pretty good. How... Do I have a save data? I don't want to just start in the main thing, because we've all seen it. We've all seen the Awakening thing and listened to GLaDOS and all that. It's great, it's fantastic, we all love it. I'm not even being sarcastic here. Okay, oh, look at this. It might also be OBS. Making it have a harder time. Oh, I'm, like, way late into the game, I think. Maybe not way late. Look at that. You can see Shell in the reflection in the... That is cool. I like that. Absolutely pointless in this game. There is no need. There is no need for it. Alright, what was it? Alt-X? Yeah, here we go. It's only using 36% of my... GPU, so the CPU must be bottlenecking it, or something is. DLSS, the upscaler, enabled ray tracing, ray construction, preset quality. Alright, well, let's lower this a little bit. Let's lower that. Oh, wow, that is so much smoother. And keep in mind, what it's doing here is it's taking a lower quality image. Let's see if it... I'm pretty sure it'll even tell you. Like, no. I could have sworn somewhere in here it like told you like what the resolution it sets to. Which is something like freaking 480p or even lower than that, I think. And then using AI to upscale it. And when you set it to higher settings, it looks more or less just fine. And again, I don't know if you can tell in this video specifically because of YouTube and all that, but it just kind of makes it like softer and a little warbly, and but that's what it has to do in order to make this game have the RTX lighting where I can see Chell's reflection in a dang thingy and have it run at an acceptable rate. I don't know if you can see that or not, but it's almost like, I want to call it Van Goghing, you know? If you know what I, if you know, like, it almost looks like it's being hand-painted. Which, you know what, in that sense is kind of cool, actually. But the whole point of RTX is supposed to be more realistic, isn't it? Hey, holy crap. I hope you can see what I'm seeing up there on the wall, up there on the ceiling, on the wall up there. There's some sort of effect happening. Now, I'm not complaining about any of this. I'm just like trying to bring up some talking points and some things to think about here. My poor computer's fan is still going crazy. I'm gonna shut that down. Wake RTX. I remember a lot of people complaining about this thing when it first came out. And I'm just sitting here like, it's a free update. Chill the hell out. I don't even think this version plays the music. Turn that down. I hope that... I'm pretty sure they chose Quake 2 exactly because of, like, the skylights and the fact that there's a freaking glass window right there, right in front of you at the very beginning. Don't break it. And you get the flare. I don't know, it just felt like people were like afraid that this version of Quake 2 was gonna like replace the original or something, like that's what the intent was. No, I don't think so. The intent was to like show off this new budding technology and show off the potential and give people something real and tangible to play, like that they don't need like a ridiculous ultra supercomputer to do. So hence why you would pick like an older game like this and add the technology to it and add textures. Add the textures that always bothered me. You put explosive barrels there and they don't even blow up the thing. I have to do it myself. Yeah. Which buttons? Oh. And turn on the resolution scale. You can't even tell the difference because of that DLSS thingy or whatever I was talking about. Graphic settings, RTX. Da 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 da. resolution scaling options, dynamic resolution scaling, targeted frame 60, which is, you know, what I usually go for, just because, and this isn't necessarily new technology either, because if you remember, Doom 2016 did something very similar in, like, its console ports. And that was kind of weird, and, you know, nowadays, you know, it's weird to think that this game that was, like, blowing everyone's mind is, like, relatively easy to run. There we go. That just kind of... now it's clear to me. It's nice and crispy. This texture here looks like it came straight out of Nintendo 64, though. That's another thing that always bugged me about Quake 2, is your crosshair is not honest. Your bullets come out of your gun wherever they're pointing, and it doesn't try to compensate. The remaster fixed that. The remaster fixed a lot of my problems with Quake 2. And it's like my favorite way to play it. I just think, like, RTX is really cool, but we gotta, like, we gotta be careful about it. We gotta be careful and not just rely on it. And I was thinking, like, alright, other than the whole Doom 3 thing I was talking about, like, what other, like, gameplay practical uses could there be for it? Well, this is something, this made me think about, if it's on here anyway. Denoiser, where's the one that lets me move the moon? That wouldn't be in there, would it? Effects? No. Screen? Probably not. Environment setup? Oh, I can do this. Sun elevation? Oh, I don't have the gamepad trip. Or I could do that. But I can move the sun around and change the lighting. Now it's noon. Oh, I thought my gun was like clipping, but he's just pulling it back. Yeah, you can do that, and I was thinking maybe you could use some sort of game where you're playing as some sort of light source, or some character with some sort of light source, and it's like a puzzle game that involves, like, mirrors and reflections, like solar panels and stuff like that. I feel like that's just one idea, that's just one example. There's hundreds more if I really sat down and brainstormed it. But I just feel like, you know, there is potential beyond just making things shiny. But anyway, that's it. That's my rant. That's my ramble. Thank you for watching.